G'day, g'day, g'day. Sam from Bendigo Vinyl. And this is...
Paul.
And we're coming to you from the wonderful world of Zoom to have a chat to you about something that dropped last week. And if you followed us on the Instagrams, you might have seen my immediate reaction to it. But I thought it might be a good opportunity to have a chat with Paul about it. Look, Paul, I've had a week now to really process this and have a think about it. So I'm a little less angry about what we're about to talk about than I was then.
Yeah.
You may have talked to me at the immediate point when I just listened to the new Red Hot Chili Peppers song, Black Summer.
Mine is on the dark side of the moon. Hit me now.
And I wasn't in a good state.
You weren't in a good place at all. When you said... If you followed us on Instagram or Facebook, you might have seen your reaction. You might have seen Sam lose his shit. and I got like the special behind the scenes version of that. I feel like you're always very excited about the Red Hot Chili Peppers. I feel like you're always very excited about new release from then, particularly when the half a dozen times Frusciante's got back in the band.
yes.
But I don't feel like you've really been impressed ever when it's happened.
No.
So, no. Yeah, I thought you were getting your hopes up. But how are you feeling about it now?
So I'm feeling a little better about it now because I realize that my music taste is a lot broader, which will happen when you run a record store with somebody, and a lot of different genres and a lot of different guitarists and a lot of different, other instruments as well that I listen to now. So my self-worth is less tied up with whether a Frusciante written guitar song for the Red Hot Chili Peppers is any good or not.
Yep.
It didn't always used to be like that, Paul. We did a big review of Californication where that album meant too much to me when I was growing up. And yep. We kind of went back and we're like, is this really as good an album as we thought? And you'll have to have a look at that on the channel. I'll put the description down below to see how we came down on that. But I was really, really excited when I heard that Frusciante was back. And then I think from the first few chords and especially the pretty tepid vocal melodies that Kiedis puts in the verse and the chorus. And
Tepid's a good word.
Anthony Kiedis has always been simultaneously the most exciting thing about the band in terms of like his live persona and that sort of thing. And also just the giant stone that is wrapped around the legs of this band that hold them back with his nonsensical lyrics, his, barely thought out melodies. And now he's getting auto-tune involved as well. You could really hear a lot of the pitch correction on the verse and the chorus, Paul. I really struggle with this song. It also, I've done a sound engineering course in the meantime since Frusciante left the band, and this might be one of the worst mixed songs I've heard this year as well, Paul. Just a bit of a mess.
And it was... Who mixed it? It was somebody that's meant to be good, wasn't it?
Yeah. Well, he'd worked with Frusciante on a lot of his solo albums, and he'd done, I think, Stadium Arcadium. So he'd done, some recent stuff with them. He's done better work,
As much as I didn't like Stadium Arcadium... It probably sounded like sonically, I think it was fine from my vague memory of it. My one listen to it because I wasn't a fan. I think it was when you're excited about this, a part of me was just like, why? Like, I didn't see the reason to get excited about it. What are your thoughts? Like, are you just going, are you thinking the same thing? Like, wait, why was I looking forward to this as much?
Yeah. I wonder if that's what it is. It's more a reflection on myself and my music tastes and them developing rather than a reflection on a band that at this point, these people are 50 years old and they've been making similar kinds of music for, generations now. I don't know what I expected. And I want to tell you something, Paul, because I think this probably didn't help. You may know that I'm a mildly big fan of a band out of England called Radiohead, and I wouldn't be the only one in that category. And Tom York and Johnny Greenwood, the two kind of main creative forces behind Radiohead, formed a new band called The Smile. And I got really excited because they were doing some live stream concerts in London and they were going to live stream them to different you know, in different time zones, and there was an Australian one, and I bought my ticket, and I like on a Sunday night at 10 p.m. and I sat down and I watched them, and they were doing these new exciting things, and it definitely sounded like Radiohead, but it was, there was also some really cool ideas and polyrhythms and different kind of synth arpeggios and like these real soundscapes that they built between Johnny and Tom and the drummer. And I was really buoyed by that. And then Black Summer comes out 3 days later. I'm like, will this be the same? Franchante's back. Will they be re-energized? And unfortunately, Radiohead's in the minority of bands that are superb and excel and push the limits and are pretty critically acclaimed the longer that they go. These albums pass into myth, like every single one that they release. Kevin Parker's a little bit like that with Tame Impala, but these and David Bowie definitely was that before he passed as well. But those people are in the minority in a huge way. We don't have many of them still alive at the moment. Like there's no Beatles left. Zeppelin broke up, but the U2, Coldplay, Rolling Stone thing, and now I guess Red Hot Chili Peppers as well, where you kind of recycle your old vibes to a new audience, gets a little bit.
I think something that I might say on that is like, so you've compared, I feel like comparing Radiohead and Red Hot Chili Peppers is very much apples and oranges. And this isn't necessarily saying I think one's good and one's bad, because I'm not the biggest Radiohead fan. Like I like they're obviously good, but yes. I've got my favorite maybe two albums or so, and you could probably pick which ones they are. But comparing them and Red Hot Chili Peppers is, they're just so different. Radiohead are, you know, they're a musician's band. Their most sort of pop song they can't stand. Me thinking it's got more merit. I think Creep, worth speaking about, obviously, has got a lot more merit than they give it. Whereas they like their weird shit. Yeah. Very different type of band and different, a different audience as well. The Red Hot Chili Peppers, at the peak of their powers, so we're talking Blood Sugar, we're talking Californication. Yeah, they had some nice melodies, catchy choruses, but it was fun, it was silly. They were, you know, socks and playing naked and all this sort of stuff. Like, you know, and there was punk influences. Punk died in about 3 years. That's the joke. And it was done. To compare them to another contemporary, though, if we speak Oasis...
Yep.
You know, they had a couple of things, and they had a couple of albums after What's the Story that weren't quite as big, but then they broke up and won't get back together. And I've heard Noel say in interviews before, he's like, nobody wants to hear 50-year-old, 60-year-old Oasis sing Supersonic and Live Forever and stuff like that, because it doesn't hit the same, because these were youthful songs that had a certain attitude about them. And when the Chili Peppers were at the peak... That it's just like seeing like your parents do like hang out at a bar and like, you know, they're all dorky and stuff. And it's not like, that's what it feels like when you see the Red Hot Chili Peppers now. What they're trying to do just doesn't fit. Just let it go. Go and do something else. But yeah.
I 100% agree. They released a big statement on their Facebook though that kind of showed that they're maybe taking this a little bit more seriously than I am. They, you know, talked about how like they were in a new energy and space, and there was like this different vibe around the band now, and it was like this really long thing. Yeah, the new
space is a nursing home.
Yeah. And it's in the lead up to their April release, which we will definitely stock at the store, Infinite Love. And you betcha I'll listen to the whole thing all the way through, because I can't help myself. I'm a sucker for punishment. But this kind of like, they think that they're breaking ground, that potentially they're not really.
Yeah.
But I think I need to come to terms with the fact that that's okay. That, you know, a lot of my favorite bands have done that. I'm a big U2 fan. We're well past the Joshua Tree. That's never going to happen again. Mm. We're well past Rush of Blood to the Head for other Coldplay fans as well. You know, there's a lot of these artists that are, you know, I'm holding out hope for a new Peter Gabriel album. He hasn't released one in like 20 years, so I doubt it's going to be any good if he does. But I'm really, really excited for it. I guess we can't help ourselves. And I guess it kind of goes to the power of the old music and what it has over us. We're seeing a lot of these artists, Paul.
Yeah.
Bob Dylan, Sting did it yesterday. David Bowie's estate did it recently. Bruce Springsteen did it for the biggest price ever. They're selling a lot of their like master recordings and like publishing rights for huge sums of money to record labels, because I think we keep going back and listening to these old songs, and maybe that needs to be enough for me. That's like, if I want to listen to a Red Hot Chili Peppers song, I'm not going to listen to Black Summer. That was really ordinary, but I might go back and listen to Blood Sugar Sex Magik or Californication or Can't Stop.
Yeah. I think it's, for me, the one of the distinctions, and I'm not sure, this Chili Peppers interview where they seem to be taking it quite serious, I think throws me off it for some reason. And it's maybe because, like, so Rolling Stones...
That's not the history of the band, is it?
Yeah, big Rolling Stones fan, but they... they've released so many records. They've been playing for so long, but and they were obviously like, sorry, I just burped into the microphone then. Don't drink in YouTube. A message from Uncle Paul. But the Rolling Stones have released records, but I don't feel like they care about them. Like, what they care about is they're like, well, what do we like to do? We play music and like to write songs. So I'm going to get together with a bunch of people I know that I'm good at that with, and I'm going to do it. And we're the Rolling Stones, so why on earth wouldn't we record it? And why on earth wouldn't we put the album out? Like, but they're not expecting, they're not going out doing interviews being like, oh, this is the best record we've made. No.
Yeah.
They're well aware that the best was, you know, Let It Bleed or something of within 3 years of that. I'm right.
Very right. Very right.
But so maybe it's, you know, I'm not going to begrudge the Red Hot Chili Peppers releasing an album. I don't think anybody's asked for it. And I don't think nobody's asking. So don't pretend people are. Don't pretend everybody was waiting for this amazing record. But release it. Cool. Go do a tour again if you want. You know, we'll come see you. We'll see an older version of you, you know, sing Give It Away. It's fine. Yeah. But yeah, I just think it's... They've released a new song. It's not great. It's potentially the most average chorus I've heard in a while. But it's
pretty, pretty rough.
It's very rough. But like, it's fine. It's just a pop song, but don't expect Blood Sugar.
Look, Chad Smith sounds like he's still having a good time on the drums. That sounded like old Chili Peppers, and not in a tongue-in-cheek way. It sounded like he's just been doing the same thing, and he knows where his bread's buttered. So that was good to hear, but the rest of it was a little bit rough. And I think maybe in my old age, I'm going the opposite of what the meme is, and I'm way more excited about new music and new artists and what they're bringing to their genres and to streaming services and on vinyl now than I am about some of these older artists. We've got a couple of shout outs that, like, if Chili Peppers and this latest one is your vibe, that's fantastic. Leave it down in the comments. Let us know what you thought of Black Summer, and are you looking forward to Infinite Love? But if you kind of want to get a little bit of a vibe of what's going on, like, what was the next step? Because Blood Sugar Sex Magik was 30 years ago, Paul. That's so long ago, right? That's literally the last really good Chili Peppers album was 30 years ago.
Yeah.
31 years this year. So, that's a long time ago, so maybe you might want to listen to some new stuff, Paul. And I've got a good shout out.
Go for it if you love
a bit of kind of jangly guitars, you know, clean riffs, some indie punk attitude, and some kind of spoken word lyrics, which is how Keita started out with that kind of like rap thing.
Yeah.
But you want a little bit more intelligible lyrics. My recommendation is a band out of Leeds called Yard Act. They're a new kind of indie punk band out of England. They just released their debut album, Overload, and it's absolutely fantastic. So Yard Act, that's my English punk recommendation, Paul, which is, I know, very far away from California funk rock, but we live in 2022.
Yeah, and you know, that's it. We're a global economy now. And funny you've picked a band from Leeds, because I'm also going to recommend a band from Leeds.
That's crazy.
I will get to that. If you say California, you know, punk rock, have a listen to some ska bands or something, like some ska punk. There's a big scene in California that's Chili Peppers adjacent, I guess. Like, they had that, some sort of those vibes. But back to Leeds. And this does tie in, because Kiedis has been doing this Iggy Pop impersonation for a while. Iggy Pop cosplay, as you called it, Sam, which is great, because it's, again, no one asked for that. But Iggy Pop, love him. Give this band a shout out. Give him his endorsement a little while ago. A bunch of 17-year-old school kids from Leeds.
That's really young.
Lit Objectif. That was really difficult to say that.
Say that 10 times fast.
Yeah, so give them a listen as well. Endorsed by the guy that Kiedis is trying to get endorsed by. Have a listen and let me know what genre you think they are. Because they are, I wouldn't say all over the shop, it's a cohesive sound. They are very rough still, like early Chili Peppers, which I think is a great thing. But very excited for their first long release, long play.
Yeah, if definitely. If you will. Head as well to www.bendigovinyl.com.au, and we've got a ton of local punk rock up there that is just excellent, Paul. We got The Chats.
We got the Chats, Amel and the Sniffers. Nice. We'll get some Skegs in there. And again, if you liked Chili Peppers and you clicked in this video, been like, oh, let's hear some good things, and then you haven't, have a listen to some of these guys. If you like that sort of like early Blood Sugar Sex Magic vibes, where it's just real youthful and energetic and fun, give them a listen, because you can go see them live now and they're not going to be 50.
Yes.
And it's great. Like, there's a lot of new music out there that does things that people want them to do that they don't hear on, you know, your main radio stations necessarily. So check them out.
Awesome. That's some great stuff. And let us know what you've been listening to in the comments below. Like, subscribe to all that good stuff, ring the bell, and visit www.bendigovinyl.com.au and have a look at some of the stuff we've got in stock. Order yourself some wax, support artists, support local, and hopefully we'll have some news about a storefront for you guys soon, a physical location here in Bendigo that you can come and visit and chat with us and maybe buy some records
and maybe play some live original music.
Wouldn't that be good? Have you got anything you're working on? That sounds
secrets. We'll see what happens.
Yes. So until next time, on behalf of Paul and I, we will see you when you flip the site.